I'll start by creating a new Java project. It's going to be WebSocket project 08. And from the previous project, I'm going to pick up javax.json.jar. And Tyrus standalone client, and I'm gonna be using those in this project. Properties and Java build path. Next, I'm gonna go to this JavaFX download 2.0.2. And gonna accept the license agreement and download this guy, the JavaFX SDK. And for my machine, it's Windows 64. Next, I'm gonna double click on my downloaded JavaFX. And I'm gonna be installing it in the default location. And I'm gonna go back to my project, go to properties and Java build path, and I'm gonna add the external jars. And I'm gonna add this guy, the JFXRT. Next, I'm gonna create a client class that's gonna be in this package. It's gonna have a main method and it's gonna extend from application. That's gonna be JavaX, JavaFX dot application. Now from main method, when I call lunch, it's gonna start call the start method for the JavaFX. And here, let me have a text field. It's gonna be javafx.scene.control.text field. And a button. And an hbox that is gonna contain both text field and the button. So I'm gonna do hbox.getChildren.addAll text field and send button. And I'm gonna have a stack pane. And I'm gonna add the hbox to that stack pane. And with JavaFX, I have a stage, and I have scenes on that stage. So I'm gonna go ahead and do stage.setScene and add a new scene that is gonna include the stack pane and the size 210 by 20. And for now, what I'm gonna do when the button is clicked is to just clear out the text field. So I'm gonna have a send button dot set on action event, and all what I'm gonna do here is text field dot clear, and next I'm gonna do stage dot show. So before adding the WebSocket code, let me just test run this to show how a very simple JavaFX application works. So run as, so here we go. So I have a text field and the send button, and if I enter anything here and click send, it's gonna clear it. So now let me do stage dot set title. It's gonna be WebSocket tutorial 08, and I'm gonna add a text area. It's gonna be the messages text area, and I want the focus to go to the text field initially, so I'm gonna set the focus traversable to false for the text area. And it's not gonna be editable. I'm gonna set it from the code, and I'm gonna create a B box, and I'm gonna add the text area and the H box from here to that V box. And in the stack pane, I'm gonna be adding the V box instead of the H box. And let me set the size here to 250 by 200. And next, I'm gonna have a chat room client endpoint. That's gonna extend endpoint, and I'm also gonna have a chat room message handler. That's gonna implement message handler dot hold, now in the chat room client endpoint, I'm gonna have a session instance variable. Gonna be setting it here in the onOpen method. So this dot session is equal to session. And I'm gonna need this session in order to send WebSocket messages. So I'm gonna have a send message method that takes in a string message. And here I'm gonna do session.getbasicremote.sendText. I'm going to be sending that text message. And let me go ahead and define a constructor here. And for this tutorial, I'm going to be using the WebSocket Project 02 as a server. So to access it, we go localhost 8080 WebSocket Project 02 and the chat room server endpoint. So in my constructor here, in chatroom client endpoint, the URI is going to be WebSocket Project 02 and the chatroom server endpoint. And I'm going to do container provider dot get WebSocket container and connect to server, and I'm gonna pass it this, so this chat room client endpoint instance and the URI for the server. Now in the chat room message handler, I'm gonna need to display the message in the text area. So on the on message event, so what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna need the text area somehow passed in. So I'm gonna get it passed in the constructor and set it as an instance variable. And then I can use it in the on message method. And the message coming in from the server is gonna be a JSON message. So here I'm doing build JSON data. When I send text and build JSON data, it's gonna send a JSON string. So in the onMessage method, I'm gonna pick up that JSON and pick up the message from it. So get string message. And I'm gonna put it in the text area. Now in the chat room client endpoint, I'm gonna need the text area passed in the constructor. So that I can pass it to the message, to the chat room message handler. So I'm gonna do session.add message handler. So this is going to be the message handler, chat room message handler. And now going to the client, I'm going to instantiate a chat room client endpoint, passing in the text area. And use it to send the text that's in the text field. So text field dot get text. Gonna do chat room client endpoint dot send message. And I'm gonna clear the text field afterwards. Next, let me go ahead and test run this application. So I'm gonna start the server. And let me go ahead and start the client here. Actually, let me have more than one. So let me do this BBB, and this is CCC, and let me have another client also. And this is DDD. So this guy sends a message, they're all gonna receive it.